Okay, so now let's go ahead and think about what we call a firm's production function. And the production function tells us how much a firm can produce with a given amount of inputs. So, how much total product, also called quantity of output, from a given set of inputs. And in all the examples we're going to do in this series of video lectures, we're going to look at the firm's total output and how it changes as it changes just one factor of production. So we're going to look at total product as a function of a single input as that input varies in the short run. So in particular, we're talking about a short run variable input. So the variable input would be something like the number of production workers. And what we're doing here is we're going to keep constant, hold equal, the other inputs that we have. So we're going to go ahead and use an example of a farm here in a second. And we're going to assume, say for instance, that the number of acres of land or the amount of equipment or animals or whatever that the farm has to work with stays the same, because those are relatively hard to adjust. Obviously, if we adjust those other inputs, that's going to increase our total production level as well. But we're going to go ahead and start with baby steps and just look at varying one input at a time. So, what would this look like? Well, we can go ahead and start with a chart, and we're going to talk about the quantity of labor and how that influences total product, the total amount of production, or quantity of output. I'm going to try and avoid talking about quantity here so that we don't get confused with quantity of labor. So, if we have zero workers, say for instance we produce zero, and if we have one worker, say we produce 19, if we have two workers, say we produce 36, if we have three workers, say we produce 51, I don't know, this is like bales of hay or whatever, it doesn't really matter that much. So four workers, let's say we have 64, five workers, 75, six workers, 84, and seven workers, let's go ahead and say we have 91. Okay, and let me tilt the camera down a little so you can see that last row there. Okay, so here we go. We have a quantity of an input, or quantity of labor, total product, and like we've seen a lot of times before, we're interested in the marginal here. So the marginal here is what we're going to call the marginal physical product of labor. Because right now we're going to measure productivity in terms of the actual physical output that someone causes to be produced. So this first worker increases our production by 19. This second worker increases our production by 17. This third worker, so third worker takes us from 36 to 51, so increases our production by 15. Fourth worker takes our production from 51 to 64, so has marginal productivity of 13. And so on, and so forth, down the line. So, marginal physical productivity. So that's one way of measuring productivity. We could also measure average physical productivity of labor. average physical productivity, we would take total product and divide by the quantity of labor. And so this would be, you know, dividing by zero. That's not going to work out for us. Here, the average productivity and the marginal productivity for the first worker are the same. But when we go here, the average productivity is 36 divided by 2, or 18. And notice the average productivity, 18, is the average of the two marginal productivities. When we go to calculate the average productivity when we have three workers, we would have 51 divided by 3, and I think that's 17. And notice 17 is the average of 19, 17, and 15. So the average level of productivity for any given level of workers is the average of all the marginals up to that date. Okay. And if we have 4 here, we would have 16, which we should double check this, but it should be the average of 13, 15, 17, and 19, which you can kind of see, right? These two are below, these two are above, so 16 is going to be here in the middle. And so on and so forth here. Average is 15. Average is, I don't know what 84 divided by 6 is. What do you think? So 12 would be 6 times 12 would be 72. 78 would be 13. So I'm going to think that this is 14. And so on and so forth here. So out there in doing real world stuff, we can almost always directly measure this, and we can almost always directly measure this. Measuring the marginal actually is a little bit trickier, unless we really have sequentially added workers in this way. More confidently, what we can almost always predict is that the marginal productivity at any given point, except at this very low level of production, the marginal productivity is almost always less than the average productivity. And that's something worth noticing, that if you're sort of thinking about whether or not a certain worker is worth it, are they, you know, adding more to production than they are costing me, we'll get to later, you want to keep in mind this contrast between average and marginal productivity.